right of you. Here at the University of Cambridge, a team of researchers have been hard at work implementing cutting-edge scientificology in order to maximize student productivity. The result is this, a scientific showcase in the pursuit of that most curious of phenomenons, laughter. Scientists were perplexed by the presence of such an unusual reaction, especially when presented in seemingly ordinary, everyday environments. In this doctor's office, is there anything particularly wrong with this diagnosis? Or how about this doctor's reaction to apparently harmless and nutritious piece of fruit? Why would one be curious about the order of these two objects? Did this big fellow precede his smaller friend? Or was it the other way around? And then why would this larger chap be found in the middle of this road? All questions that would need to be answered by the team. In order to establish a link between these seemingly mundane events and laughter, a test was devised. A suitably sized banana was peeled, and the resulting peel was then placed in the middle of a busy pathway. What would happen when an unsuspecting member of the public walked by? The results were collated and graphically represented in this graph of laughter against funniness. At first, the laughter builds directly with funniness before reaching Blyton's plateau. Then, it continues to rise before sharply descending into Freudian sleep. It then rises back up to Timothy's peak of uncertainty before crashing down to the... Oh, that looks like a W bit, rising sharply to peak laughter before plummeting down to...
Goodbye, my lover. Goodbye, my friend.
Laugh, Why Don't You? Has been put together by the safe fleshy meat hands of Molly Stacey and William Dalrymple.
I really enjoyed working with Molly, working for me. You know, Molly's not like the other girls. Oh yes, there are others. I do employ a lot of women, you know. Because you see, it takes them so long to do anything. You know, it's one thing, as a businessman, that you need five women for the one man. But the wonderful thing is, it still works out cheaper. but you see, Molly here is cheeky and plucky. Not like the other girls. With them, it's all cheek, you know. Can I go on holiday, they ask. Can I go to the toilet? Can I give birth in a fully sanitized hospital? I don't know. Can you? Not that with Molly, though. She's cheeky and plucky and has no immediate plans for motherhood. I like that.
Now, you're probably thinking Molly is very new in the Cambridge comedy scene, and you'd be right.
Well, actually, Mr. Dalrymple, over the past few years...
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Until one day, I saw Harriet and the other girls laughing by the water cooler in the office, and I thought, hello, that's a laugh. So I stalked up to them and demanded to know what meant was so damn funny, and, what did she say? What did you say, Molly?
Please leave me alone.
Then I was laughing. You know, I must tell that one to my bridge partner, Dylan. He's the other president of the Cambridge Footlights, and he's baffled by women too. Though I did teach him my jelly bean trick. Watch this. I think you'll be impressed. Will you work hard today, Molly? See? It really works.
You will still get me onto the Footlights Committee, won't you, Mr. Dalrymple?
Shh, Molly. Not now. Right in front of the man. What did I tell you? Cheeky and plucky. Think about Molly is. She's not a looker. She's not much of a thinker either. But my God, is she a secretary.
Co-director.
Yes, that's right. Co-director.
Yes, I am.
Make your way to Pembroke New Cellars on the 21st and 22nd of February at 9:30 p.m. and laugh. Why don't you?